Someone asked, "Have you ever seen the man whose back has become hunched, his hair gray, his steps heavy, and his teeth lost, and trying hard to pray, fast, and obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now, but is not able to, as a result of feebleness? He was once young as we are now." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "Istajibu lillahi wa lirasulihi idha da'akum lima yuhikum." Oh, answer the call of Allah and His Messenger whenever they call you to that which gives life to you. Hence, from this verse, we can understand the simple logic here that we are dead people living if we are not on the path of truth. Hence, Allah said, "Istajibu lillahi wa lirasulihi idha da'akum lima yuhikum." To that which gives you life. There is no life except the life of a mu'min, except the life of a believer. Hence, we all are dead people walking if we are not charged with spirituality. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has asked us in so many places in the glorious Quran to follow Him and follow His Rasul. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "Qul in kuntum tuhibbuna Allah fattabi'uni yuhibbukum Allah." Allah said, if it is your proclamation and it is your claim that you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell whoever is making any such proclamation, expressing his love for Allah, tell him that the legitimacy for the acceptance, the legitimacy for his love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is kept in his obedience to you, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hence, if you love Allah, then you have to follow the footsteps of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. O young man who has got strength and ability, know that one day all these gifts will depart from you and you will yearn for them. So be productive now before they are lost. Every day, the day cries out, "O son of Adam, I am a new day and will be a witness to what you do. So take advantage of me, because once I leave, I will never come back until Qiyamah." Oh, young man, if you're too stingy to give Allah some of your time now, I bet that the coming years will prove you to be stingier. Oh, young man, be certain that a day is coming when sickness will exhaust us, pain will overwhelm us, and we will wish we had worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as He ought to be worshipped. وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهِ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ. O young man who claims to have been endowed with intelligence, why do you take the risk and hope to live long enough to repent? Be productive. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, when the time for our death comes, there shall not be any delay or any advancement as to it. Whenever your time is up, you are going to die. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "Kullu nafsin dha'ikatul maut." Verily, every soul shall taste death. Ibn Kathir, in the exegesis of this verse, what did he say? He said, "Aynama takunu yudrikkum al-maut, fakunu fi ta'ati Allah, wa haythu amarakum Allah, fa huwa khayrun lakum, fa inna al-maut la budda minhu, wa la muhidun anhu, thumma ila Allah marji'un." Ibn Kathir said, wherever you are, death will catch up with you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, "Aynama takunu yudrikkum al-maut walau kuntum fi burujin mushayyada." Even if you find yourselves hiding in fortified forts, Allah said, it is easy for us to take your soul wherever you are. Hence, do not be deceived by your young age that you still have time. There is no time to waste time. Oh, young man, know that the highest level of delusional comfort a sinner attains is having hope in Allah's mercy, forgetting that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is severe in punishment. Our Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, take advantage of your spare time before you become too busy. Allah took an oath by time. Allah said, "Wal asr, inna al-insana lafi khusr." إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, والعصر. Allah took an oath with the absolute time. Time, the past, the present, and the future. Allah took an oath with it. Allah said, verily, man is in loss. Verily, by the vicissitude of time, by the reality of time, the existential reality of time, man is subjected to perpetual loss. With the exception, Allah made an istisna. Allah made an exceptional statement. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, except those who believe in Allah, وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, and they do deeds of righteousness. They are not only comfortable with their belief in Allah, but they are also coupling it up with what? With righteous deeds. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, take advantage of your spare time before you become too busy. Someone gave a brilliant advice. He said, oh you, be selective in the company you keep and do not befriend evil people. At this juncture, I would like to interject objectively and take us through the world of the glorious Quran. In Surah Al-Furqan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَيَوْمَ يَعَبْدُ الظَّالِمُ عَلَى يَدَيْ يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِ اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا يَا وَيْلَتَى لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أَتَّخِذْ فُلَانًا خَلِيلًا لَقَدْ أَضَلَّنِي عَنِ الذِّكْرِ بَعْدَ إِذْ جَاءَنِي وَكَانَ الشَّيْطَانَ لِلْإِنسَانِ خَزُولًا. Allah is painting the image of the regret of a sinner who has taken for himself an evil companionship, an evil friend. Allah said, on the day of judgment, you only see the sinner. He will be regretting, biting at its fingers, saying, had I know, I would have followed the path of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Had I known, I wouldn't have taken so and so as my bosom, my intimate friend. وَقَدْ أَضَلَّنِي أَنِ الذِّكْرِ بَعْدَ إِذْ جَاءَنِي. Verily, he misled me after the truth has come to me. After the scholars have told us that it is haram to commit zina, it is haram to consume alcohol, it is haram to consume shisha, it is haram to consume everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made haram, it is haram to cheat, it is haram to lie, it is haram to expose our nudity, it is haram to do this and that. After being exposed to the reality of all these things, that it is haram to go clubbing on a Saturday night or on a Friday night or whenever we choose to do that, we know it is haram. Allah hasn't sanctioned it. After we have had the reality of this in the masajid and in the manabir, where the scholars have spoken about it, we choose to follow the path of our friends. Allah said, he will regret it when he sees the azab. He said, had I known, I wouldn't have chosen so and so as my bosom friend. Today, he has misled me after the truth has come to me. Allah said, remember, Satan is ever a deserter in the time of need. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again in Surah Al-Saba, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is painting the image of the regret of a kafir. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَن نُؤْمِنَ بِهَذَا الْقُرْآنِ وَلَا بِالَّذِي بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ وَلَوْ تَرَى إِذِ الظَّالِمُونَ مَوْقُوفُونَ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ يَرْجِعُ بَعْضُهُمْ إِلَى بَعْدٍ الْقَوْلِ يَقُولُ الَّذِينَ اسْتُدْعِفُوا لِلَّذِينَ اسْتَكْبَرُوا لولا أنتم لكنا مؤمنين. قال الذين استكبروا للذين استضعفوا أنحن صددناكم عن الهدى بعد إذ جاءكم بل كنتم مجرمين. وقال الذين استضعفوا للذين استكبروا بل مكر الليل والنهار إذ تأمروننا إن نكفر بالله ونجعل له أندادا وأسروا الندامة لما رأوا العذاب وجعلنا الأغلال في أعناق الذين كفروا هل يجزون إلا ما كانوا يعملون أو كما قال الله تعالى. Allah said, those who disbelieve, they said, لن نؤمن بهذا القرآن, we will not believe in this Quran, ولا بالذي بين يدي, and will not even believe in what came between it. ولو ترى إذ الظالمون موقوفون عند ربهم. Allah said, if only you will see, Allah fast track the events of Yawm al-Qiyamah. Allah said, if only you will see what will happen when the dhalim, when the sinners, the wicked people, the oppressors, the polytheists, Allah said, when you only you will see them, mawqufuna in the rabbihim, when they stand in front of Allah, yarji'u ba'dhum ila ba'din al-qawl, they will create a blame cycle. One part of them will be blaming the other part. Had it not been because of you, I would not go out clubbing. Had it not been because of you, I would not go out consuming alcohol. Had it not been because of you, I wouldn't have committed zina and fornication and adultery. Had it not been because of you, I wouldn't have cheated my parents. Had it not been because of you, I wouldn't have disobeyed Allah. Had it not been because of you, I would have prayed on time. They will be blaming one another. Allah said, then the weak ones will be blaming the oppressive ones. Lawla antum lakunna mu'mineen. Had it not been because of you, we would have been believers. Qala alladhina istakbaru, the arrogant ones in their lot of arrogancy, they will say to the weak ones, anahnu sadadnakum anil huda ba'da izja'akum. Did we force you to disobey Allah after the truth has come to you? Did we force you? Did I point a gun at you that you should follow me to club on Saturday night and Friday night? Did I force you to commit zina? Did I force you to consume alcohol, shisha, marijuana, embalming fluids, the ecstasy? Did I force you to consume all these things after the truth has come to you? Bal kuntum mujrimin. Bal, you yourself are a criminal. That was why it was easy for you. There were so many people that saw us doing this, but they never followed us to clubbing. They never consumed alcohol as we did. They never committed zina. They never visited the soothsayers. But because you yourself are criminals, hence you followed us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kept telling us about the reality of these people. Hence, my old youth, do not fall victim to this. Fast, optional, voluntary fast, as they are a protection for you in your youth. He who wants to chill must learn how to spend in charity, because it destroys any hardship on our part. He who preserves his time and does not waste it in what displeases Allah, Allah will preserve for him his religion and worldly affairs. The greatest energy a man will dissipate is the energy required to start an action. We have learned a lot. What we just need is that energy to get us started. We need to start, we need to be sincere in our quest, and we need to define our goal. Do we want to be a party of Jannah, or do we want to be a party of Jahannam? I pray we choose the former. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspire us with righteousness.